Okay. This is the next day. I finished construction last night, Sunday evening, and plugged it in, and just as I was about to plug in, battery in the camera gave up. And I decided to plug it in and see, and it worked first time, which I was very happy about. But I didn't get that moment on camera, but it doesn't matter, because it's more about having the construction filmed. And after watching a bit of footage, I changed my mind and decided to try and put the camera on the left, so that, in theory, right-hand soldering, we can see sort of what I'm actually doing, whereas before I was blocking the view a lot of the time. But what we have is a completed device, clock, CPU, ROM, RAM, IO. So next are two extra modules, with the Pi Zero and the IO. And I think, quite looking forward to the Pi Zero, so my feeling is I'm going to do that one second and do the IO, which has an absolute bucket load of stand-up resistors, which I think I've decided I don't like. However, doesn't matter, we can plod on. And soldering iron is hot. So let's have a look, see what we got in the bag. Now this one is a bit different in that, not really massive solid instructions to be going on. So it's a bit make it up as we go along. However, soon lots of things should be fairly straightforward. And what we have is, what do we have? We have a chip and another chip and another chip, three chip holders, bucket load of switches, bucket load of LEDs, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 LEDs, 2, 4, 6, 8 switches, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then it should be, this is a conundrum. Again, first hurdle, we're going to have to, unfortunately, look at the picture. So, DigitalIO. In theory, it might be labelled on the schematic, which I should have printed out. That's a no. We've got ours listed. So we're going to have to look at the picture. Okay. It looks as though the lights are using the orange-orange-brown, which is about 300 ohms, which I think was the same as the backplane, 300. Perfect. Whereas the switches are using a 2K2. Perfect. So as ever, we have the resistors, we have this, and then by the looks of it, there's a couple of links. And given that I have a surplus of extra single line risery things. I think we might do a bit of a jobby on those. Like that. Two of those. Two. Okay, I guess where shall I start? Now the pro tip said LED cathode marked K is short lead, so the LED short lead goes into K, which is on the left hand side here. If I can be clever about this somehow. Hopefully I don't muck any of the chips up. Squeeze them out. Okay. And the chips, right, and these. I still suspect that there's a magical way to solder. Let's get back into the rhythm and start down it. With the chip holders, why the hell not? Okay. Well, I guess you can't see anything still, but... So I really tipped my soldering iron. Which hopefully should make this either a lot easier. Alright. Okay, here goes. First joint with the new iron, soldier iron to it. That looks nice. Okay. Let's do one on each corner. So, I think in the spirit of okay, here we go. I wonder if that's in the shop, let's have a look. Well, not too bad. What I might try and do is zoom in just a little more. All the way to 55, that's all I got. boiling. Right, let's see how we did. This one is novel. So. The switch has got to switch this way. The problem going on there. I'll spike all that and go this way. Very difficult to make these uniform. It's definitely a fiddly little board. I'm still sweating away.
Okay. I've got anything small enough to.
It's not too bad. I'll definitely reflow that. That's hot still. Camera turned off. Okay, that's a bit more pressure this side. Something to lean on. I thought that was pushing. That will do. Okay. Good. So now we just run down the line. Of course, you still can't see anything. Go like that. Not great, not bad.
That is too big for a jumper. Which is a bit annoying. That way is too big. Shall I go anyway? What are we doing for time? 9:10. Right at the time. Much of burn it in. Just about fit. I don't know if this is a good idea or not. But we will find out. Like that. That's not too bad.
Okay, well, now the bit that I've been waiting for, of course. So I'll do all the resistors first. So, starting at the right, there were the switch ones, which were the these are orange, orange, brown. These are the switch ones. So in theory, that should be a 2K2. Sound. What was a loose thing? It's the switches. Them that way around. The diagram, opposite around to the diagram, we mounts them this way. Now they're still in the way of the switch a little bit. I wonder if I could do something creative. They're not really in the way. Okay, let's get on with the bending process. There's an old school trick to do this very efficiently that I don't know about as well. Okay. I am going to follow the diagram. And Nothing.
There's a couple of not so good joints there. That side is fine. This top right one could use a bit of a reflow. That's it. I might have done it. These resistors on first, we've been able to make the rest of it, haven't we? I'm sure it was the right one. Okay, might be a bit of a
That will do. Well, it's not too bad. So, okay, let's give those a bit of a reflow up down this side. Okay, there we go. Rotation again.
Same deal, I guess. Seemed to work reasonably well last time. Well, let's finish this board. A few more bits. There and anywhere I can get them really. Okay, let's run down the line. Camera stops again. Shh.
things.
Okay, here we go. Okay, which just leaves LED, so it was just to double check. LED cathode marked K as short lead, so presumably it's the same for these. K is the short lead, which is that. How far? The same height. As the resistors, I guess, making it neat. What time is it? How are we doing? We're still filming. 9:30, which isn't bad. I'm a bit tired. Just do them bang up. I'm not quite a fan of that. Sellotape. Maybe. has seriously got to be an easier way. Not too shabby. Almost done. Reflow these and now some of these definitely haven't got enough solder. That was very, very light. So if we go down the circles. Squares.
Okay, so now for the chips. Three chips. Small one obviously goes in the small hole. But it is a 74HCT138N. Got the old right angle. Jobby. Let's just pause there. And resume. Okay, so where were we? A tiny bit more. Definitely seems that once they're straight, you can just almost drop them in. So now we have two types. We have 74HC4374, 70HCT24. So this one is the right one. Easy, I'll cut that slightly. Okay, board complete.